Hello, I'm Rene. Welcome to this tip and trick. We're going to talk about transformations without using a dialogue. The first one, position is fairly straightforward. Just click and drag the object where you want it. Using the control key, it will constrain the object or better set the movement horizontal or vertically. Scaling, also very straightforward, use one of these corner points and drag them to the size you want. Using the Shift key, we'll size the object from or to the center. Using the Control key, we'll size the object incremental. Distortion, just one of the side handles, and again using the Shift key from the center, using the Control key in incremental steps. Rotation. Make sure the object is selected. Click it again. The rotation handles will appear. Drag them to rotate freely. Use the Control key for incremental steps of 15 degrees. Skewing. Just use one of these handles here. And also for rotation you have the origin point. If you move it outside of the object or to any position you want, you can rotate around the origin point. If you want the origin point back to its original location, press the Control key and drag, it will snap to its original location. Now one that isn't that obvious, and it is mirror an object, excuse me. First we're going to convert the curves, delete one of the corner points, so you can see him better. Mirror an object is actually nothing more than scaling it around an axis. But if you do it manual, like this, you never get the same size on the other side. So we use a helper key, control key, drag, wait till the blue line appear, release the mouse button, and you have the object mirrored. Control key, drag, wait till the blue line appears, press the right mouse button once to leave a copy behind. There we got the object mirrored with a copy. You can also do it around any corner or using any handle you like. Let's say we have the following situation. I want to mirror this object and I want the same distance I've got here on the other side. We need some helpers, a guideline, and we draw a temporary rectangle. We click it to the guideline. Wireframe, make sure you draw it exactly against the guideline. Then select both objects, control key, drag, blue line appears, tap the right mouse button once, release the left mouse button, there we got a copy on exactly the same distance as here. If I want to do this vertically, there are several ways. The easiest way is, of course, guideline in the center. Excuse me, first the helper object. Select all three objects, drag with the control key, click to leave a copy behind, and there we have it. Well, let's add a circle. Wait till you see the red, little red square indicating that it's snapping to the center of the guideline and, or better said, the crossing of the guideline and the object. Shift key, Control key, Shift for drawing from the center, Control key for making a perfect circle. Click it once, drag the corner point to the center of the object, which is the center of the crossing of the guidelines. Rotation handle, Control key for incremental steps, right click to leave a copy behind, and then Control R to repeat the last movement. It was mirroring, excuse me, transformations, without using any dialogue. Very efficient in your daily workflow and will speed up your work considerably. Thank you for listening and I'll see you the next time.